Hi, I'm Sean Rice from the International Tour of the Addams Family, and this is Gaming Out of Suitcases' playthrough of Elder Sign by Fantasy Flight Games. Elder Sign is a cooperative game, meaning that all the players work together to try to defeat the board, which is actually playing against you like another character. You take on the role of investigators who are exploring Miskatonic University's museum, where a bunch of strange events have been occurring because of the Ancient One's imminent rise. By overcoming these encounters, the investigators hope to collect Elder Signs, which are ancient symbols used to keep the Ancient Ones at bay. But the clock is always ticking, and every night at midnight, the Ancient One gets a little closer to coming out into our world. If the Ancient One does wake up, all the investigators will come together in one final battle with it, which is nearly impossible and will probably end in death. Here's how it works. First, the game is set up like this. The museum entrance sheet, clock set to midnight, and the pool of dice is set up at the top of the playing area. Next, the Ancient One is chosen. Now, just like our investigators, the Ancient One has a lot of qualities that will affect how the game plays. The Ancient One's Elder Sign limit. This lets you know how many Elder Signs you have to collect to seal that Ancient One away. The Doom Track. This is basically a countdown to when the Ancient One wakes up. Now, some of these spaces just report imminent doom, while some of them show where monsters enter the museum. And final battle information. Now, if the Ancient One wakes up, this shows you what the investigators must roll to successfully attack it, while this shows you exactly how the Ancient One is going to fight back. Next, you'll remove all the mask monsters, unless Nyarlathotep is the Ancient One, and put the rest of them in a monster cup, or pile, or bag. Now, shuffle the adventure cards deck, and deal 6 cards face up underneath the Ancient One. Each card represents an adventure that can be completed. The bottom of the card shows you what you will lose if you fail the adventure, and what you will win if you succeed. You win adventures by rolling dice to complete the task listed on the cards. Now, you always have access to 6 green dice, but using items can sometimes add a yellow or a red dice to your pool. Yellow and red dice give you more chance of success because they have more investigation and lore icons, and less peril and terror icons. The red dice even has a wild icon, which lets you choose what icon you need. When you try to complete a task, you will roll your pool of dice. If you've completed that task, take those dice and set them off to the side. Then move on to your next task using only the dice you have left over. If you didn't complete that task, you will lose 1 die from your pool. You get to choose which. Every time you try, you'll lose a die. If you ever run out of dice before you've completed all the tasks, then you have failed the adventure. Very sad. If you fail the adventure, then you have to pay the price. If you succeed, then you get to reap your reward. You also get to keep the adventure card as a trophy, and replaced it with a new adventure card from the deck. The remaining adventure and other worlds card should be placed face down near the adventure area. Next, just shuffle all the spell, common item, unique item, and ally cards and place them somewhere near the adventure area. Separate all the sanity, stamina, clue, elder sign, and doom tokens and place them in an area where everyone can reach. Now decide who's going to be the first player. Then, everyone will randomly select an investigator from the pile. Each investigator has a few starting qualities. Sanity. Now, this keeps track of how sane you are. You will lose this as you come into contact with horrible creatures. Stamina. This tracks how well your body's holding up. If you come into contact with a lot of dangerous things, you might lose some. A special ability. Every character has one special thing that no one else can do. Starting items. This is what your character brings with you into the museum. Items can be very, very helpful in completing adventures. If at any time during the game your sanity or your stamina reaches 0, that means you are
devoured.
Which means you add a doom token to the doom track, and you lose all of your trophies and items and will start again the next turn as a new character. Finally, the first player will resolve a mythos card. He'll turn over the top one, look at the top, and that will show you what will immediately happen, like adding a doom token or a monster. The bottom portion shows a lingering effect. This will take place over the entire next turn until another mythos card is turned over. Okay, now we're set up. How do we play? Each turn is broken up into 3 small phases. First, you will take your investigator's token and move it to any of the adventure or other world spots, or the museum entrance. Secondly, you will resolve the card that you landed on. If you've gone to the museum's entrance, you may heal 1 sanity or stamina for free, or you can use any trophies that you've collected to heal fully or to buy items or elder signs. If you've decided to go to an adventure or other world card, you can use any items or abilities that you have to give you extra dice and then start to try to complete the tasks. You'll notice that some of the adventures have an arrow next to the tasks. This means that these tasks must be completed in the order that they're listed on the card. If there's no arrow, you can pick and choose the order that you want to complete those tasks in. Other adventures list a terror effect. This means if you roll the dice and fail to complete a task, but one of the icons you rolled is a terror icon, then you have to look at the top and resolve the terror effect that's listed there. They're never good. Still, other adventure cards may lock a die. If an adventure locks a die, you must place that die on the card until the adventure is completed, meaning no one may use that die at all for any of their adventures. In addition to all of this, the Doom Track and some Mythos cards will add monsters into the mix. When a monster is added, you must place it on a card that has a monster task. Now, this may take the place of a task that's already there, or it may be in addition to all the tasks that are on the card. If there are no adventures with any monster tasks on them, then you get to choose which adventure you want to add it to. Though, if you add it to one that has an arrow on it, meaning you have to complete everything in order, you must place the monster at the bottom of the tasks, meaning it's an extra task that you have to complete at the end to finish that adventure. When a monster is defeated, you get to take it off the card and keep it as a separate trophy, even if you end up failing the adventure. Tricky, eh? Well, it's not just all luck. There's a couple things that will help you in completing these adventures. Clues. If your investigator has a clue token, he can use it to re-roll one, some, or all of the dice that you just rolled for your current task.
Spells.
Now, spells allow you to secure one die. Once your dice have been rolled, you can select one and place it on your spell card, and it will keep there until you need it. Now, what's cool about a spell is it will keep there until anyone needs it,
even in other adventures.
But if any time you decide that you want that die back, or if another character wants that die back for their turn, they can just take it off and the spell is broken.
Now, when you use a spell, you still have to discard one die if you fail to complete the task.
Focusing. One time per adventure, you may focus one die. That means if you've not completed your task, you can take one die and set it on top of your character's marker. It will stay there until you need it.
Asking for assistance.
Once per turn, you can also ask for help from any character who is also on that adventure. If they choose to help you, you can focus a die onto them as well. Now, here's the catch. If you fail the adventure, the person who assisted you must lose either one sanity or one stamina.
Unlike spells, all unused focus die are returned back to the pool at the end of your turn.
When your adventure is over, whether you have completed it or not, you will move on to the third phase, which is the clock phase.
During the clock phase, you simply move the clock hands ahead 3 hours.
If this brings it up to midnight, the first player will resolve the next Mythos card and then pass the first player token on to the next player.
As the game progresses, you will slowly start to collect elder signs. Now, if you collect enough, then you win.
However, if the Ancient One's Doom Track fills up before you collect your amount of elder signs, then he will wake up. And that's never a good thing. Well, that's it in a nutshell. Let's take a look at the playthrough. Okay, here we are. We're here with Mark, and we're going to play a game of Elder Sign. We have already chosen our characters and set up the game, so it's all ready to go. I am playing Dexter Drake, and he has a 5 stamina and 5 sanity, and his gift, his ability, is Magical Gift, and each time he gets a spell, he gets an extra spell. And he has 3 starting items. He's got the Book of Zen, which gives him the ability to use a red die. He also has Heal, which allows him to heal any investigator's stamina. And Find Gate, which will open up one of these other world activities for us to do. And Mark?
I have Michael McGlynn, the gangster. He has 3 sanity and 7
stamina.
He's a strong body. Once per roll during his turn, Michael may change one die showing a
terror icon.
Terror result to a
peril.
Peril.
Mm-hmm.
Result. Cool. Okay.
And he's got his 2 starting items, which give him a yellow dice apiece. Wonderful.
Okay, and our creature that we're fighting, our Ancient One, is Yig. And as you can see here, he has, I chose him because he has only 1, 2, 3, 4, 8 places on his Doom Track, so he's going to be a shorter game. We need to collect 10 Elder Signs, And Everett says over here, every time we kill a cultist or every time one of us is devoured, then it adds a doom token to the doom track. All right. So I'll go ahead and be the starting player since Mark is new to the game. And I'll take Dexter Drake and I'm going to put him on... Here, A Terrible Discovery. And I chose that one, as you can see, because it offers an Elder Sign and two clues if I win, or I only lose two sanity if I don't, because my sanity is 5 and Mark's is 3. It's a better deal for me to try to do it than Mark, because, you know, you don't want to be gypped on all your sanity right away. Alright, so I've got my green dice here, and we're going to roll into this little bucket so it's easier for us to keep everything in one place. Now, for our first task, I've got to roll 3 investigations and 1 terror. And when I do that, I get to lose 1 sanity, or I can choose to roll 2 lores, and I also get to lose 1 sanity. So let's see what I roll, and then I can choose which one I want to put it towards. All right, so I have rolled the 3 investigation and 1 terror. So I'm going to take those. Oops, I knocked it over. You saw it was there. And put it here on the card. And I'm going to lose my 1 sanity because of it. So now I'm down to 4. Okay, so now I'm going to roll again. I rolled 1 lore, not 2, so what I'm going to do is focus this one, put him on my piece here, and then I have to still lose a die out of the pool, which gives me 2 chances to roll 1 lore. Nope. 1 more chance to roll 1 lore. And I did! Wonderful. So I unfocus that. Well, I had it there. Just put it over here. And I lose my other sanity, so now I'm down to 3. But good news is I did complete the task. Oops, sorry for my camera work here. I did complete the task, so the dice go back. I end up back in the museum, and I get to take this as a trophy, which gives me, as you see, 2 trophies, plus 2 clues, and 1 elder sign. So we are 1 elder sign closer to winning the game.
Yay!
All right. So now my last thing that I have to do is move the clock ahead. So I move the clock from midnight to 3. All right. Now it's Mark's turn. We do put a new card down. Thank you. All right. We've got the loading dock.
Okay. I think I'm going to try for... Oh, that loses 1 sanity, but I've only got 3. I don't need sanity. Maybe I should try for this one. Forgotten knowledge? Maybe?
Yeah.
I think so. I'll put my little guy there. And then I have to pick up the dice.
Mm-hmm.
And I just have to roll 1. I got it.
You did? You got 1 more?
Yep, 1 more. Where am I? There I am.
All right, so now you've got to roll 1 terror and 8 investigations.
Okay, with...
So what I'm going to suggest...
Should I do one of these?
I would suggest trying to use one of those, because that's going to give you a yellow dice, which has a 4 investigation instead of just a 3.
Ah, yes. Sorry.
So you can choose either one you want.
I'll get rid of that one.
Okay.
And I'll take that. Okay, here we go. Let's hope for the best.
You have your terror, and you've got, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Well... The pity is, you can't do it halfway. You've got to have the terror and all 8 to do it. But what you can do is focus one of your terrors and lose one of your other die and re-roll. And now all you have to do is try to get the 8 investigations.
Come on, come on. Let's do it. Oof.
You got 6. Well, keep trying. That's all you can do now.
Okay, so I take 1 out.
Mm-hmm. Oh, three.
I don't think I can. I can't do it.
At this point, no, your highest you get is seven. Yeah. So at this point, you failed the adventure.
Ugh.
Which means you lose one sanity.
Okay, that's not too bad.
Yes, it is. Your person can stay there.
Oh, he stays there?
You can move him next time, but okay. He stays there just because he didn't complete it.
Okay.
But you do move the clock ahead.
To 12:30.
Well, two.
There?
Yep, to six. All right. So Dexter Drake, out and about again. Dun, dun, dun. Dexter Drake is, let's see, where else do we have an elder sign? He's going to go to the koi pond. Now the koi pond has a terror effect. Mm-hmm. That terror effect says if you roll a terror icon and you don't complete the task, then you immediately fail the that adventure. So I have two things to do. I have to get a terror, and then I have to get a terror and two perils. And if I succeed, I get an elder sign, I get a common item, a clue, but sadly, I also get a monster, which is not good. But I do have my two clues from before, which I never took, so I have them here. And I know right off the bat that I'm going to probably need those, so that's good. So... I'm not going to use my red icon just yet, because the red icon, as you can see, has peril, but doesn't have any of the terror markers on it. So it's not going to be as helpful for this as normal. It would be if I get the wild, but the chance of that is not very high. All right, so, rolling the die. I rolled... a terror. So I did get the one done. Actually, I got a terror and a skull. Only one skull, though, so I couldn't complete that. So, terror it is. One terror down. Now I need a terror and two skulls. If I roll a terror but not the two skulls, then I automatically fail. Well, the good thing is I didn't roll a terror, but I didn't roll any skulls either. So I lose a die. And here we go. Skull. I'll go ahead and focus my skull. Lose a die. So now I have to. I only have two dice. I have to get a terror and I have to get a skull. I got a terror, no skull, which means terror effect anyway, I automatically lose. So I lose one sanity and two stamina. Very sad. Alright. And I move my clock. To nine. We're getting very close to the mythos. Oh, I should have used nice clues. I totally forgot about them.
Oh!
I talked about it and I didn't use it. Well. Sad day. We'll remember that for next time.
So, I can move from here now?
Yes. You can stay there or you can move anywhere you'd like.
Go over here.
Awesome.
That one looks a little better. So...
Sorry. Pardon my reach.
No.
Down to two. Okay.
So I can get two clues and, what is that?
A common item.
If I win.
Correct.
Okay, so...
And this is one that you have to do in order. So you have to get two investigations.
I got two investigations.
Perfect. So now you've got to get... Four investigations.
There's four in there. Three and a one.
Perfect. Now you've got to get one lore.
Whoops. Slipped over that one. Sorry.
No problem.
I don't know where it is.
That's okay.
There it is. And now I have to get one.
One lore.
I got
it. And you did.
Yes.
Perfect.
Fantastic.
So you have finished the guided tour. Go ahead and take two clues and one common item. Your common item is an old journal, nice. Which gives you another yellow.
Nice. I'll take that.
And don't forget your two clues.
What are my two clues?
Those are these guys here.
See if they're going
to
be
cool. You're going to go back to the museum entrance.
Excellent.
And we put over a new...
Card. Yay.
The archives.
What are those?
Those are the swords. Are unique items. Oh. They're more likely to give you red dice, while the common items are more likely to give you yellow dice. Okay, so now we move the clock, and look, lo and behold, it is midnight, which means first player will resolve a mythos card. So I flip this over, and as you can see, it has the two sections. The top says, the right tools. Add one doom token to the doom track, or the investigators as a group must discard two unique items. We do not have two unique items. I only have one, which means we must add a doom token to the doom track. So we're going to do that right now. And the one he's covering is a monster space, which means we also get to add a monster. So I'm going to randomly select a monster from the monster pile. I've selected, of course, a cultist. Because if we kill a cultist, then we have to add another doom token to the doom track. All right. So I've got three choices here. I've got one, two, three, actually four, that have the monster spaces. This one, as you can see, to kill this cultist, all we need to do is to roll a skull or a peril or a lore. So it's an either-or situation. I'm going to say that it's probably going to make it easier if we put it here and take out that one terror. So now here at the Koi Pond, instead of having that one terror icon, we can now roll a skull or a lore for that first section there. Cool. Now, that is our immediate effect. Our lingering effect, it says, create a rift. The next time the clock strikes midnight, each investigator must discard one ally if able. So we'll leave that in play. So if we get any allies, then we know at midnight they're going. Okay, which makes it my turn again. So Dexter Drake, am I going to try for that?
For the monster.
I'm going to try for it, even though the monster's there, we're going to have to kill him anyway. So I'm just going to stay here at the Koi Pond. Going to roll. And as you can see, I rolled no terrors. But I did roll a peril, so I can use that to kill that cultist. Cultist dead,
yes.
Which adds another doom token to the doom track, but no monster this time. But we're up to two already. Okay, so cultist dead, wonderful. So next, I've got to roll my one terror and two perils. So let me go ahead and do that. I rolled a terror and two perils.
That was great.
So, I'm not going to put him there, but I did it. So, as you can see, now what we're going to get is another monster, a clue token, I get a common item, and another elder sign. So, we're two elder signs in for our 10. So, let me take in my clue, let me take my common item, which is a revolver. It gives me another die. And I get to keep this cultist as a trophy. He is one trophy, so let's put that over here. All right, Elder Sign, and I get to keep the card. Thank you, Raymark. All right, so we get a new card down, which is the Public Lavatory, which, as you see, has two monster spaces on it, which is apropos as we get a new monster, which happens to be... Ooh, he's a nasty one. He's a magician. So he takes two things to kill him, either a terror or a peril. But he locks a red die, so that red dice is now gone until someone kills this magician. I'm going to put him here in the public lavatory. So that's where he's going to be.
I just lost his clue.
On the floor somewhere.
That's right there.
Thank you.
I'm blending into the carpet.
Okay. All right, so moving my clock. We're now at 3, and it becomes Mark's turn.
I think I am going to... Should I try for that?
Right now, I think that's our best bet, too, because it also gives us two elder signs.
Uh-huh.
And he's not that hard to beat.
Okay. then why don't I go to the public laboratory?
Oh, you know what? Okay, I didn't read this. Public laboratory. When a player draws this card, draw two monsters and put them there. So, all right, so he would have gone there anyway, plus this monster, this zombie, has to go there.
Okay.
And then I have to pull another monster to be the one that I thought I was pulling from before, from killing the cultist. Or from not killing cultists, from doing the doom track. So I've pulled this guy. He is a flying pileup, and he's pretty nasty. He's easy to kill, but he takes away one stamina and one sanity. So I'm just going to pop him over here. All right.
Okay,
yeah. So it's still not all that hard to kill.
I'm going to try it.
We're going to lock that die away so we know that's gone. Yeah. You can do them in any order you want.
There's nothing on this thing, right? So it's not really worth...
Well, there are skull... There is a skull in that. It would add one more die to you to have a skull. That's the only
I think I'll do that.
Because you have two, so...
So I've got to... Yeah.
Yeah. Never hurts to have an extra die.
Come on, skulls. And the one I put in is a skull.
That's funny. You also have a terror icon there that you could use if you wanted.
Can I do a skull and a terror?
You can to kill yeah. him, yeah. So that red die is now unlocked, so we're going to move that off of there. Because he's dead.
So he's dead.
He's dead. So now...
I can go for the next monster.
You can go for the next one.
Do I use all the dice?
Use all the dice, because you succeeded in that task.
So... I got a skull. Or a terror.
Either one you want. It doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter. Cool.
All right. Okay. So now you have to roll a skull and two lures. So a peril and two lures.
Can I lock this guy?
No, because you can only focus when you don't succeed in your challenge.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
You got a skull, so you can focus that this time.
Okay.
And then you have to get two lures
on
your next one. I mean, that's your only chance.
Oh, I have to lose a die.
You have to lose a die as well. So you only have two, so it has to be two lures for you to win.
Come on. Ugh.
Nope. But look at that. You've got two clues.
So what am I supposed to do?
You can spend a clue, and you can re-roll both those dice.
Ugh. Let's try it. Ugh.
No. Well, you have another clue. You could try.
Let's give it a shot. Why not? Come on. Oh.
So sad.
Oh.
All right. So you are going to be losing one sanity and one stamina. You do get to keep those monster trophies.
Yes. Yay.
It doesn't say anything on there about replacing them once you take them away. So that's a good thing.
But I didn't get anything.
Is he... He's zero. Return marker to the cup and gain two clue tokens. So you killed him, so you got two more clue tokens.
Oh, okay.
You don't get to keep him, though.
I think
that one you do, I think. Yep, that one is a one trophy. Perfect.
Fantastic.
All right. So you lost your sanity and your stamina. Did that kill you?
No.
Did you already lose it? Okay, good.
Yep.
Good.
Because I had seven.
Moving the clock ahead. All right, where am I going to go? I think I'm going to jump right in there with you and just try to knock this out, because now it's a lot easier because those monsters are gone. I'm going to hold off on using any of my items to see if I need it later on, because, you know, no use in wasting them if I don't have to. But I also have three clues, so that's good. All right. We're looking for a peril and two lures. I have one lure, so I'm going to go ahead and focus him. Lose one die. Now I'm looking for a lure and a peril. I have another lure. Mark, would you like to assist me?
Do I give a clue?
No, you don't give a clue. If I fail, you would lose one of your stamina or one of your sanity. You can choose.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Yeah,
so we're going to focus this onto Mark, because he's here. That's useful. And I'm going to lose a die. So I've got two now to try to get one peril. Nope. I'm going to use this clue, though, so I get to roll again. Peril!
Yes!
Bum, bum, bum. So, now we've done this. Mark doesn't lose anything for helping me.
Yay.
Plus, we get two Elder Signs and two monsters.
Great.
We both move to the museum entrance, because that's where we start. I'm going to take this guy as my trophy. I give myself two Elder Signs. We're now up to four out of our 10 that we need. But we do have two monsters. We also get a new new thing called the Elder Sign, which gives us an Elder Sign, so that's good if we defeat it. Okay. It's the only one on the board right now that gives us an Elder Sign. And our two random monsters are going to be the Witch and the Warlock, which again locks our red. Okay. So one has to go here. One has to go here. And that locks our red. Thank you. Move that clock ahead. And now it's Mark's turn.
Oof. I've only got one sanity. So.
Well, you can choose to stay at the museum and heal one sanity. I would say because you only have three, I wouldn't waste trophies on it because...
Right. I've only got... Yeah. I'm going to stay there and get one.
So you would heal yourself one sanity this turn.
Yeah. I think that's the best...
But that counts as a whole turn, so now we move the clock ahead.
Oh. Oh.
It's okay. Needed to do it. Now we're at midnight. So, if we had any allies, they would be discarded. We do not. So this time... Horrible monsters! Either add one doom token to the track, or two monsters appear. Alright, we have a decision. What do we want to do? If we add a doom token, we get a monster anyway.
Right.
If we don't... Then we get two monsters.
I say, let's do two monsters. They might be easy. They might get lucky.
Let's see. Two monsters. What are they? Well, one, two. Looks like we've got a cultist, which will move the Doom Drake anyway. And we have a high priest, which will lock the red dice once the...
red dice is unlocked?
Red dice is unlocked again. All right, so let's choose where to put them. Let's put one here at the Forgotten Discovery. And we'll put one here on the loading dock. We'll just set him here off to the side. So we have a monster in every space except for the Elder Sign space. Awesome. The rest of our card says, reveal a secret. The next time the clock strikes midnight, each investigator gains one clue token.
Oh, okay. Take that.
It's not too bad. Not too shabby.
Well, we have got 1, 2, 3, 4 times before. But...
Yeah. All right. Okay, so. What am I going to do? What is most useful for me? I am going to... You know what I'm going to do? Is I'm going to use this spell that says Find Gate, discard to draw one other world card, and place it with the six adventures. So, I'm going to take one of these special other world cards. Ah, I chose the Dreamlands. If I succeed, then I get two clues and an Elder Sign. And it's fairly easy to succeed. As you see, there's only a peril, one lore, and three investigations needed.
Nice.
So that pops up down here. I'm, of course, going to go there because that is the most... That's the nicest one on the board. It's fairly easy.
Hopefully.
But I have to get them all in one roll, as you see.
Oh.
Because they're all on the same task.
Oh. Yeah.
All right. I have a peril. I have my three. I do not have a lore, but I have clues. So I'm going to put my peril off to the side. I'm going to put my three off to the side. And then I'm going to use a clue to reroll just these guys. That's what's nice about the clues. You can reroll one, some, or all the dice. Huh. Well, here's the other good thing. I have a 3. That gives me an extra die now for my second clue. Aha. I need a lore. And I have one! Ba-da-bum! So I get 2 clues, and we get an elder sign. There we go. And I get to keep that as a trophy. Thank you for my clues. Replenished what I used there. Not bad. All right.
An elder sign.
And an elder sign. Now we're up to 5. We are halfway there.
Yes.
All right. Clock moves to 3.
Okay. I think I am going to go for... As I throw it on your lap.
There we go.
Good catch. I think I'm going to go for... I think I'm going to try this. Lose 1, 2... Well, if I lose 1, 2... If I don't get it, I'm dead, right?
Well, when you succeed, you have to lose that 1 stamina and 1 sanity.
Right.
But then, if you, let's say you get for the through those top 2 and you don't do the bottom one, then you lose another sanity.
So I would lose 2 sanities and then I'd be crazy and dead.
Right. But you may not. You may succeed.
Let's give it a shot.
Let's give it a shot. This may be an instance where you would want to use one of those yellow dice.
I think so too. Okay. Here we go. And I have to do it in order.
Have to do it in order. So we're looking for 1 lore.
There it is.
1 lore, which means you lose 1 sanity right now.
Boom.
Boom, dead. All right. You need 1 more lore.
Do I lose a dice?
No.
No. Good. Another lore. Here we go. Come on, lore.
Oh. Lore! Yes. Thank you, yellow dice. Lose 1 stamina right now. Brings you down 3. To 5.
So 1, 2.
Okay. Now you need 2 investigation and 1 lore.
Lore
and 2 investigations. Yes. Congratulations.
Nailed it.
So you get 2 clues.
2 clues.
We get an elder sign, but we also put a doom token on the doom track. Okay, so now we're up to 6 elder signs, which is great. And we have an extra doom token on there. Did you already put the Doom token on there? I think you did, right? Yep.
I think so.
Yep, and that gives us another monster. That monster is... Ooh, it's a Migu. Alright, let's see if we have a place where we have to put him. We do. So, our Migu goes here, in the gate to elsewhere. Alright, and our clock moves forward. All right, so we currently have nothing on the board that is going to give us an elder sign, which sucks. But we do have some monsters on every single card, and we do have 2 places that will give us another world, which may, you know, give us the elder signs. So, what am I going to do is the question of the hour. I'm going to go... why not? I'm going to go to this new place that we got, the gate to elsewhere. So, in any order, I can either kill the Migu, which is 2 investigations and 1 peril, or a lore, and 2 lores to finish it off. So let's see. Let's see what I got. I still have 2 clues as well, which is nice. And I do have a revolver, which gives me a yellow die if I need it. So what have I got here? This one's kind of on the side, but let's see. I can do the 2 lores right away, I know that. So I'm going to just do that now without looking at those. Which gives me the 2 investigations and lore or peril. I've got the lore and the peril, but I didn't get the 2 investigations. So let's keep the lore, and we'll use a clue to reroll. Ugh, 1. All right, I'm going to use my other clue. I'm going to keep this, because all I need to roll is one then to get it. And one! Ba-dum, one, one, and that kills that. Okay, cool. So that's done. So we open up a new world, and I get two more clues to replace the two I just used. So I'll just leave them there and not redo it. I also get a Migu, and when you flip him over, he doesn't have a trophy, but he says, return to the cup and gain one unique item. So I put him back over here, and I take a unique item, which gives me a healing stone. It says, before rolling, discard to fully restore your sanity and stamina. Wow. So not bad.
That's nice.
Yeah. We also get our other world, which is Relay. Good thing is, if you win, you get one ally and three Elder Signs. Bad thing is, if you lose two stamina and two sanity. Oof. It's not too difficult. Not too difficult. All right. I'm back over here. I get my trophy. And our next thing is Did You Hear That? Which sadly locks a green die. So now we're down to five dice. Whoops. Sad. Five dice. I suggest that is one of the next ones we do, because once we kill that, then we can have our green die back.
And it also doesn't have a sanity loss, which I can't afford, so that would be perfect.
Yeah. All right.
Well, you know where I'm going. You have to go to that guy. And this doesn't have any heads on it, right? Oh, it does.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I don't have
a... But you don't have a thing anymore.
You have another card. You're locked. Oh, my gosh. Okay, I've got five dice to get three perils. Here we go. Oh, come on.
One peril. One peril. That takes care of that top one.
Okay.
Now all you need is two more perils. And you have four clues,
yeah,
so...
Yeah, I have four clues, so I ought to be able to...
One peril. Let's put him off to the side and use a clue. Where are all those other three? One more. Oh, don't forget your strong body.
Oh, I could have done that.
If you have a terror icon, you can make it a peril.
Oh.
You did have a terror icon, though, right?
I did have a terror icon earlier, but that's all right.
But you rolled a peril anyway, so perfect.
Perfect, so I... Boom, that's
success.
Done.
So what you get is a spell, a common item, and we get a new monster. But Great. We get that die back, so
yes.
All the die go back to the pool.
Yes.
Our new monster, by the way.
I go to the door.
Ooh, it is the Hound of Tyndalos. The Hound of Tyndalos, easy to kill, but it locks the yellow dice, and when you kill him, it moves the clock along as well.
Okay, so then I get one of those red things, too.
You get this.
Card, which is...
Ooh, Sword of Glory. One of each, and you get a spell. And your spell... so you have the Mists of Relay, so that you can lock a die for good in that, if you want.
Oh, okay.
That's your trophy. Go ahead and take your trophy card. We get Late Night Break-In.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that looks, well...
Not too bad.
Not too bad.
It's not too bad. All right, so I'm going to move that clock along again. Now we're at midnight. Ding, ding, ding.
Something.
Each investor gets a clue.
Oh, yes. I'll take that.
All right, our new mythos. The stars align. Add one doom token to the doom track.
Oh no.
He is halfway to waking, which gives us a new monster.
Yeah.
Our new monster is, of course, a cultist.
Okay.
And the bottom half, our lingering half, is amid the stillness. There is no lingering effect today. So nothing happens besides that doom token. All right. Moving on. What do we got here?
Relay. I need to get more sanity. I don't know how to get more sanity.
You can go back to the museum and heal. Just, yeah.
Yeah, I think this is going to be the next time. Oh, no, I can go after that.
So what I think I'm going to do is I think I'm going to go to relay.
Cool.
But I'm going to, before I roll, use my healing stone to fully restore my sanity and stamina. So I'll be back up to 5 and 5. I need just a 5 and a 5. Five and five. Perfect. That way I have full amounts to lose. Because as you can see here in relay, there's a lot to lose. Oh no, I've knocked myself off. I'm down there somewhere.
I'll find you.
While you're looking, I will continue on.
Yes.
So, as you can see, I could lose 2 sanity and 2 stamina. There I am. But what I have to roll is... Now this is interesting. What you have to roll is 2 investigations, but you have to do it on 2 dice, the way it's listed here, for one of the tasks. The other one is 2 lores, 1 peril, and 1 terror. All right. So in this case, don't we have something that locks the yellow die? Did we kill that already? Did I make that up?
We had something that locked the green dice.
I thought we had something locked a yellow die. Maybe we kill it.
We killed it.
We did. Okay, good. So I'm going to use my 38 revolver then to give me the yellow die. And I have 3 clues. All right. Well, I've got my 2 investigations. Let's see. I also have a terror, a peril, 1 lore. Ooh, that might be harder to do later on. I'm going to take out the terror, the peril, and the lore. That way I only have to roll one more lore. I'm going to use my clue to do so.
Cool.
And I did. 2 lores. And because I can do that in any order, I've got my 2 lores, peril, and terror. So now this time, all I've got to do is roll 2 things of clue of investigation. 2 investigations! Bum bum, completed! Woo! So I get an ally and we get 3
yes.
Elder signs. So we were at 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8,
yes.
9, 1 to go.
Woo-hoo.
And I have a trophy and I get an ally. So this ally is Professor Armitage. Place 2 spells on Professor Armitage when he joins you. You may use these spells as if they were your own. Discard this card when you've used all the spells on it. So Professor comes with a bind monster after rolling discard to defeat 1 monster. And the Voice of Ra after rolling discard to change 1 die to the result of your choice.
Nice. That's
not really bad. Nice. Not bad at all. All right. So I'm back here. Our clock is now on 3. And Mark's turn. We only need 1 more elder sign. Nothing here. It gives us an elder sign.
But I am going to go to here. Because I can't have the sanity. I don't have to worry about losing sanity.
Oh,
what?
I cheated. Look at that. I never put him out. We did have one that locked. The yellow die.
Oh.
Well, we'll just know that I cheated and keep moving on because we're almost done with the game. But normally, you don't cheat.
Okay, so I'm going to this guy here.
Sorry for cheating.
So I'm going for either a lore or a... And then I got... Oh, my God. Whatever I want, right?
Yeah.
So let's just stick him there.
Killed that cultist.
Now I have to get 6. Come on.
I got 2. Mm. You have clues now.
Yeah, should I keep the 2?
Yeah. If to get 6, I would even re-roll those.
I was thinking 2.
Yeah. Don't waste it on 1s.
That's what I was thinking.
3, 6.
6.
Done.
Wow.
So you gain a clue.
I gain a clue, plus I get the monster.
Yeah. which means we put a Doom token on the Doom track because he's a cultist, which gives us a new monster.
Oh, great.
Yeah. And that new monster is an Elder Thing. Perfect. Our new adventure is Remains of the High Priest. Ooh.
Does it have a...
It doesn't, but I'm going to put it there because I'm going to put our monster there. So here's the cool thing. All right, so I'm going to move our clock along because we still have to do that. But I'm going to choose to stay here at the museum entrance and look here at the store, buy a souvenir. Well, look at that. 10 trophies equals 1 Elder Sign. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Bum, bum, bum. And Yig has been defeated. Though we cheated just a little bit.
But unknowingly.
But unknowingly. So, congratulations to us.
We won. I can't believe we actually won. I thought we were going to die. Yeah.
As you can see, the game is a lot of fun, and it's really easy to learn. And unlike Arkham Horror, which I love, you can play this game in about 20 to 40 minutes instead of 4 to 5 hours. That's always a plus, especially if you have new people who are learning the game and they're not hardcore gamers. Hopefully you've enjoyed this playthrough. If you have, please remember to like, comment, share, and then subscribe to my channel so that you can get more playthroughs like this one.
Till then, keep gaming!